Alright, it's Let's Count the Idiots on the Seawall Day. It's November 7th. It's a glorious day because Trump is no longer president. So let's celebrate. I already filmed this ride, but I thought I'd film it again because of the colors. About 6 degrees. Gee, I'm 1 minute in, I haven't passed any idiots yet. That's unheard of. Got to be somebody going the wrong way or walking on the bike path. Again, not paying attention. It's always the fucking phones. Every time. She looked at me when I was 2 feet in front of her. Trees. I've charged up to 80% as usual. Last trip was last week, which I have not posted yet. And that was a... Hey! Eyes open, idiot! See this woman? I'm screaming at her and she still didn't look. Unbelievable. Again, not paying attention. I go out here for the exercise, but sometimes the stress of dealing with these people almost negates the entire experience. Maybe I need to get a louder air horn or something. Ooh, nice clouds. That was the best one yet. Like, not even a glance. It's like blind as well as deaf. Just taking up the freaking path to stand there. Keep in mind, I'm also going very slow. Yeah, I'm in full uniform today. Gloves, three layers, jacket, toque. Why did they shut it down for COVID? She shut it down for the idiot infection. Yeah, I mentioned before how they shut down this path for 7 months. It just opened up a month ago. So that was due to COVID. But pedestrians were still allowed on the right-hand side here. Meanwhile, in Falls Creek, they have a shared bike path. The width of this bike path that you see going in opposite directions of traffic, plus a walk lane on the right-hand side. That stayed open for the entire time, with social distancing of 6 inches. Of course, because COVID preferred the seawall view, loves to cycle. in the end of September, when the weather was gone, it left. Therefore, they could open it up again. It's usually not a good idea to go on the weekends here. Clouds over the mountains. Mm-hmm. Yeah. No seals, though. I feel like that kid in Christmas Story, overdressed with his winter jacket. Look at this guy there. He's not wearing anything but a shirt. Yeah, that idiot earlier who did not see me when crossing, she's gonna get the title of this video. She definitely wins idiot of the month. I should have gotten her name and address, sent her a trophy. There's another guy going the wrong way. Only one so far, that's amazing. I'm halfway around. That's damn special. Got wet on that one. Got that on film. Yeah, it's coming up pretty good. Very nice wave action. Nice. Yeah, it's good to get out. I've been sitting at home all week recording guitar videos. Wrong way, dudes. You're gonna kill somebody. You see that sign up there? It's just so hard to tell which way that arrow's pointing. That had been a little earlier when I was taking one of these corners, that would have been a serious accident. They must be Trump voters. I'll just wait for her to catch up. Oh, that's not a good idea. Isn't that how it always is? She rode over or fell off the bike. And at the 9.5 kilometer mark, voltage started at 51.4, I'm now down to 50.5. Again, a 51.5 on a 48 volt battery is 80%. So that's what I try to charge it to. Extend the life of the battery. So after last week's trip, which was about 31 kilometers, but going mostly uphill, that was a big drain on the battery. Even though it was only at 27%, I decided to charge it again. Well, so far, three people going the wrong way. Two on scooters. And I told them, you're gonna kill somebody.
I almost went into them.
Yeah.
Cross somebody.
Like, all you have to do is hit a tight corner and they're coming at you. It already feels like the sun's going down. It's not even 2 o'clock. It's not even 1 o'clock. you're going to continue this ride to Falls Creek. Go here? All right. Sure. Go on Beach Avenue this time. Haven't done that route. Usually we head downtown. So we're going to go up to Beach, which is normally traffic only. But we get an entire lane for bikes now. And this will get you a nice view all the way up until we get to the bridge. So yeah, so far no other problems with the bike. The brakes are fine. Again, it was the cheapest possible brake pads from Amazon that solved the problem. I now have all the tools needed for quick repairs. Take it with me. Still no strange sounds in the motor. Or any squeaks or squeals. I think I've only oiled the chain once. And that's since the end of July. What was his problem exactly? He didn't have enough room to pass me? What? Plenty of room there. See if Hot Dog Man is out. Looks like he is. This guy's he's crossing. There he is on the right. What? Oh, a bear? Yeah, cool. Some guy was cycling towards me and he went like this. Dick. I don't know why. There's plenty of room. No, I was on the right side, yeah. Like oncoming traffic, there's plenty of room. Thank you. good wave action. It's a nice relaxing ride. Still on pedal assist one. Not like last week up in West Van, where I actually had to put it up to five to get up some of those hills. So I'd say on a good hill climbs, I probably can get maybe 40 kilometers on this bike. Yeah, it looks like it. Why, you don't want to go this way? You don't want to go this way? This direction. I'm going to have to act like the guy in Memento. Everything in reverse. So at least it's nice to know we can still get out in November, as long as it's not raining. It'd be interesting to test this bike if it actually snowed. Maybe next month get an opportunity to try it out. What? You want my jacket? Nah, it's fine for now. It's okay. the GoPro holder is working out pretty good. I really have to tighten it on the bar here so it doesn't slip, but it's working really well in my guitar videos as well. I used to work here. It used to be 86th Street Music Club. Saw a lot of bands in there. Let's see, what did I see? Concrete Blonde, Mick Taylor about five times, Blue Oyster Cult. That was all during the 80s. When live music was alive and well. I used to see shows almost every week back then. No more than like $5 to $8. I'm glad I at least got to experience that. Thank you. briefly. I want to take a trip up there. Take a look at this little man-made island. Tricky up here. I have to walk up here. A bit tight. There you go. And nice little place to come for lunch. Sort of hide up there. All right. Your thing is falling off there. What is this? Can I clip it on? Oh, that's what came off. Great. I was wondering if that was off the bike or not. Now we gotta go back.
Okay, we have to go all the way around the seawall then.
Unless it broke. I bet you it just came off. And I'd have to look at my video where that was. Well, let's go back. Yeah, that was the clip for the panniers. I wasn't sure, because I thought she had ridden over something. Fell off about a mile back. What? I was trying to remember where it was though.
That was where we, I think before, after the
because that's not good if we don't. Right. Well, we were already on the path.